Good morning, everyone. Are you guys awake? Okay, go come. I'm just kidding. Fantastic. I appreciate everybody taking time this morning to take a little bit of time and work on your business instead of in your business. Is that important?
Yeah.
Is it important?
Yes.
Thank you. So you can stay and help motivate here. I'm Jennifer Bagley, CEO of CI Web Group, one of the preferred digital marketing companies for Amana. And you guys, we've been working in HVAC for about 12 years now. You guys have kind of owned and occupied our business. So when other attorneys and medical companies call, we really don't even have time for them anymore. We've got around 100 full-time employees stretched around the United States and the world. And they specialize in a tremendous amount of different tactics in order to grow your business. I have a few people with me. Mike Hicklin, Chief Operating Officer, in the back. I have Scott Smith, Head of Video Production, and Kathy Marshall, Customer Experience Team. And this is part of our crew. So with that being said, you guys, today we're gonna talk about the 12-step roadmap to achieve accelerated results. We have a lot to cover and an extremely short amount of time, so we're gonna go a little fast. We're probably not gonna get to everything on the list, but we're gonna get to enough that's gonna help you generate ideas, think a little bit different in your business, and be able to make better decisions. How many of you are interested in growing your business? You wanna grow? I like that answer. I like that. How many of you wanna build a business so you can sell it and sail off into the sunset? Fantastic. How many of you generational? You have somebody you need to hand the business down to. You need to prep it for that. All of those require a slightly different strategy. Challenges, you guys get called by everybody on the sun trying to offer you a magic blue pill in order to be able to grow your business. How many of you get calls by Google?
Hourly.
And you know what the weird thing is, Google will never actually call you. You guys have a target on your back for every pitch scheme there is, telling you that it's magically gonna make your phone ring off the hook. Google calls even say, I saved you a position on page one at the top. Like they can do that. So this program is really designed to help you implement the right things in the right order at the right time so you can see progress in your business. It's about stackable performance. If you see the chart up here, there's small little puzzle pieces. What we need to do is we need to build a foundation and from a marketing standpoint that allows us to build something that works and grows and it sticks. And then add two more elements and they stick. And then add two more elements and they stick. So you receive compounding impacts on your business growth instead of simple interest. Familiar with the difference, yes? In this environment, you will see progress year over year over year, but you gotta stick to it. The majority of businesses are out there burning and churning through cash, literally burning dollars. When they stop spending, they have absolutely zero, zilch to show for it. We gotta do something different. It takes work. Anybody that tells you it doesn't, they're not telling the truth. It's not easy. It's not fast. But if you implement the right things in the right order, at the right time, you will see continued progress and growth year over year over year. Fair?
Fair.
Sound interesting? Fantastic. You guys, this is a game of skill and timing. You have a sheet in front of you. It's the one with all the stuff, the headache sheet. We're gonna start on step one. This chess game requires us to implement each one of these with precision and then continue to scale through. Without going in this order, everything you invest in will only have cents on the dollar if they're productive for your business, if they produce any kind of results above and beyond your spend. First and foremost, it's branding. It's your website. It's your home base. It's something you should own. Your website is a tangible, valuable asset that actually improves the overall valuation of your company. It's a saleable item. Your website is also where people convert. It's where they get information. It's the single thing that works 24/7, 365 days a year. It doesn't take vacation. doesn't require insurance, doesn't call in sick. It's either helping, hurting, or it's not playing a role at all, and we have to define the difference and figure out what that is. From a branding standpoint, we gotta look good. You guys, buying a heating and air conditioning system, buying a heat pump, that's not an inexpensive purchase for the average family. You have a wife at home that wants to go on vacation, a husband that says we need new heating and air conditioning system. That's a real conversation that happens all the time. If it doesn't show, there's financing options available. That's an exit. Throughout the presentation, I'll explain different exits. We got to eliminate them. And there's a lot of them. An exit is when a consumer potentially had an opportunity to come in your door, do business with you, place that call, but they exited instead. A brand can hurt. In this situation, there's a big difference between this and this. Even with the beautiful website, if the brand, if it's a logo, we design it ourselves, and I'm an entrepreneur as well. I look back at what I did when I first started. Sometimes I wonder why I'm here. We design it ourselves, we ask a friend, we ask a family member, we download something free off the internet. We've got to look the part. We have to look the part. Websites. I'm actually going to exit this, and I'm going to show you some that are in production right now because I want you to see the difference. This is a project that's currently in the pipeline. This is their current website. One of the things, how many of you filled out one of these forms, the dealer form for evaluation? Yeah, if you didn't, fill that out and make sure you leave it at the table because they'll go through and do an evaluation of your digital presence. What's working, what's not. In this environment, just give you a quick example. We have a lot of text. It's not real pretty. There's a lot of elements to it that are not performing, but let's focus on what does. When somebody lands on your website, they need to instantly know who you are, what you do, where you do it, how to reach you, do you provide financing, do you have a maintenance program, do other people love you, and are you transparent enough somebody can leave a review without moving. We can't make them hunt for important information. If there's a phone number on there, it needs to be clicked to call. We need to make sure they instantly know exactly where you're at. We need to make sure it's in line with the weather and location. If you're sitting in the middle of Arizona and you've got a beach on your site and it's called Paradise Heating and Air Conditioning, we have them mark it to, and I've seen this, I can only talk on examples. Hey, we've got to make sure that there's some connectivity. We also, so who you are, what you do. We'll get into this more in the content and SEO area, but I'm here now, so let's talk for just a second about what you do. You guys don't sell products. You resolve issues. Consumers have a problem. My feet are freezing when I'm laying in bed. My nose is cold when I'm sitting in my living room. My energy bills are too high. I've got condensation in the window. I've got mold growing in the house. They have an issue. Something's broke. Doesn't work. You guys provide solutions and services. Now, how consumers search matters. If you try and create a page on your website or a section on your website and you think that selling products is going to get you found, who are you competing with if you have product pages throughout your website? Any ideas? Any thoughts? Who also sells products? How about Amazon? Home Depot? How about the manufacturers? You guys, competing in a product market, it doesn't work, and that's not what consumers are looking for. What they're looking for is AC repair, AC installation, AC maintenance, AC tune-up, AC replacement, AC cost, AC system installation, air conditioner system installation, air conditioner system, air conditioning in a particular city. The beautiful part about the internet is it levels the playing field. All we need to know, what do you want to sell, where do you want to sell it, and create content that can be filed where people are already looking. Fair? Let me ask you a question. When you guys, so forget being a business owner, just go back to mom, dad, husband, wife, homeowner. When you need something, where do you look? What do you do? Front row. What do? You need something. You need to find a product, a service. You go to Google. What do? Internet. What do? I know you. What do? Internet. What do?
Ask my neighbor.
All right. What do?
Internet.
All right. Let me ask you this. If you ask your neighbor and your neighbor gives you a recommendation, then what do?
Then I call them.
So I will tell you.
I really have customers like that.
I don't disagree. Here's the deal. I get to speak in front of thousands and thousands of people year round, and I ask every room and have for the last 15 plus years, how do you buy? Less than 1% of any audience will say anything other than Google. And even if it's referral, and I ask, what do you do next? They say, look them up online. Let's say you find a company online. What do you do next? What do? Call them? Oh, who said that? You look for the pretty little stars. Fair? Consumers' actions are really simple. They go online, they do a search, they find, provider they want to work with, typically on the front page of Google, in the organic rankings, below the map. And then they go online and they do a search and they look to see, do other people like them? If 99% of consumers shop this way, what do I need to do with my marketing time? I need to make sure I'm an option and that it clearly shows other people like me. So being an option, it starts with this. What do you sell? Every individual page gives you an opportunity to show up in a different drawer when a consumer's looking for that particular search in that particular location. You need to be the option when and where they're looking, in the cities they're looking in, for the services they're looking. You'll notice in this design, it's more like a magazine. Consumers don't want to read 300 lines of text. Google needs to. But consumers want to see really, really clear who you are. They want to know you're a trustworthy company. They want to have some kind of personal connection. They want to know you're transparent. They want to know, do other people love you? They want to know where you work, how they can reach you. We have to make it easy. No matter where somebody goes on this page, they know there's financing options, maintenance options. They can submit a review, submit a message, leave details, schedule an appointment, request service. Anywhere from the page. Show you another one. This is a current site. We have to tell people what we want them to do, not just learn more. What do you want them to do? Request a quote, get an estimate, schedule service, sign up for maintenance, apply for financing. These are terms called call to actions, and they need to be prevalent through every website. We need to be very clear and concise with the actions we want people to take because they're looking for them. We get to see the leads as they come in. We get to see what consumers say when they fill out forms. And some dealers are lucky when a consumer says, hey, I was just on your website and I wanted to know, do you provide financing? Because for that person to ask that question, there's probably 100 more that didn't even ask. They just left because it wasn't clear and upfront. Make sense? Here's the new version. Who we are. What we do. Where we do it. How to reach you, how to reach you, how to reach you, how to reach you. And that continues. Who do we serve? What do we do? Making things interactive. Are you looking for financial options? Do you want to determine what the potential calculation or savings is for your family? Do you have maintenance programs to help a consumer save time? Let me ask you this. In your business, why'd you start your company? You want more what? Why'd you become an entrepreneur? More what?
Money,
perfect. Next. Three reasons. Why'd you start? Want more time? More freedom?
Freedom, yeah.
Those are the three things every entrepreneur starts for, but really everybody wants the same thing. Every homeowner, they want the same thing, so how do we make what we do give them more time, more money, more freedom? They all want the same thing. We have to connect more emotionally, not just technically. Customer testimonials, sign up for a newsletter, the ability to collect data and information and stay in touch with people for specials, for notifications, weather alerts. I've had a lot of those lately across the nation. Okay, so just some sites, you can tell the difference. It's really not telling them to do anything. It's not giving any direction. Old site, new site. Every year, you guys, we learn more and more and more from the data. The data tells us how people search, what they do, what they look for, how they convert, how long they stay on sites, what part of the sites they use. I can literally look at every website we did 2 years ago and I dislike them. And the websites we do today, I'll dislike them 2 years from now. Why? Because we're always growing. Not supposed to stay the same. We're not supposed to stay the same. We're not supposed to get comfortable in our business. We're supposed to want more. We're supposed to do more. We're supposed to continue to improve. Luckily, the data tells us we need to do so. Has anybody ever hired one guy to build your website? Just one. Here's the thing. In order to build a website, there's no one guy that can do it. You need all of these different personality styles that mothers just don't give birth to in one body. They don't. Designers are creative, they dress nice, they have friends, they hang out on Friday night, there's actually cars in their parking lot, their driveway. Developers are totally different. If they say we're hanging out with friends, there's not a car in the parking lot. The screen is black with green text, looks like the Matrix. Engineers, SEO engineers, these guys are analysts. They're always researching. The data drives everything. Personal opinion doesn't matter. It's all math. Social media people, they're just different. Friends with everybody, right? So we've got to make sure that we have the right resources. You guys need a small percent of a lot of resources. One person can't do it. The infrastructure behind a website, it's really technical. How long do you think technology lasts for a website in today's environment? Any ideas? What'd you say?
A year.
Technically, it's every 2 months. There is a major technology change that needs to be updated. Our goal is to get entrepreneurs, contractors, dealers to be able to have their website updated at least every 2 years, bare minimum. Your business changes, consumer changes, these little devices change, the way people search changes, the algorithm changes constantly. We can't sit in the same place and expect to do better year over year over year. All right, content. This is as simple as it is. By the way, on the left-hand side, I almost forgot about this. This lines up with the 12-step roadmap you have. If it's red, that's the step I'm on. If it's green, means it's a predecessor that has to get done in order for the other things to work. I can't have a website without content. I can't do SEO without content. Okay, so it's an impact. It's something that has to be there. All of these things are interconnected. So, when it comes down to your content for your site, literally it is simple as this. What do you want to sell, where do you want to sell it, and how do consumers look for it? It's that simple. Google is just a big filing system. You guys seen Bruce Almighty? Remember the movie? So remember when he's in that warehouse and God's standing in there and he says, everything you've ever thought, everything you've ever said, everything you've ever done is in this drawer, and that drawer flies across the entire warehouse. Every page on your website, that's essentially Google. Every page on your website has to get into a drawer. But Google is deaf and blind. It reads Braille. No text, no go. If the page says our services, where does he file it? If you handed that document, this 12-step roadmap, to somebody in your office and said, hey, do me a favor real quick, file this in the file cabinet so someone can find it later, where would you find it? Where would you file it? You can't, because we've jammed so much stuff on one page, it's impossible to file this piece of paper in the right drawer for someone else to find it in the future. Make sense? All right. Next, CRM system, conversion system. A CRM system, all it is a database that holds all your leads, opportunities, anybody that's ever dealt with your business, your website. It's not your QuickBooks account. It's a lead management system. It's something where anybody that fills out a web form on your website, the data goes into a central database, not into your email account. That database allows you to sift and sort and use it later. When you become more of an expert and you get into email marketing, text message marketing, you're gonna want that data later. So if you don't collect it up front now, when you wanna turn on the next marketing activity and that data's not there, you wish you would've put something in place. If you have web forms on your website, they shouldn't just go to an email. Because you can't sift, you can't sort, you can't export, you can't drop it into an email marketing system. We've got to be organized. Using these systems, it'll help you gain back more time and money and leverage and have more freedom. The systems will replace people. and allow you to do more faster. Next. Yes, sir? So you saw when I was on that other website how it had a little box down there? That's what we've done on our sites. There are some existing CRM systems that allow for web form integration. Some. And there's a lot of them that don't. There's businesses out there that are running a CRM system that can't connect to the website, and they're relying on people to transfer the data when it comes in, and it gets lost in translation. Well, we've built one that's a simplified version for HVAC specifically. Salesforce has one that integrates. But here's the challenge. You guys, most CRM systems, I've seen a lot of dealers purchase and few, this would be a bad day. You saw that? I've seen companies purchase Infusionsoft. So you have, there's some, pros and cons. A huge system like Infusionsoft that has forms or Salesforce, you guys wind up paying a ton of money and only using 10 or 5% of the application, not knowing anybody that can run all the technical pieces of it, and it becomes more of a drain on the business. We're all about lean and mean. I want down and dirty, lean and mean. We got to get something that's in place that you can use easily. It's easy to train your team. It works on your mobile phones. And that it doesn't have too much in there, because too much is also a burden on the company. Make sense? All right. Okay, so step number four, local listings. Local business listings, there's a top 60 local business listings account. You guys are probably familiar with a lot of these. And some I'm not even familiar with. These local business listing sites, Yellow Pages, White Pages, Yelp, City Search, Google Business, Yahoo Business, all of these are the top, some of the top directory engines that can help with local marketing. Challenge is, most companies don't manage these, and these guys have a slick way of getting you to pay for their services. They will put a listing up with your company information, a wrong phone number, wait for you to call so you can get your phone number changed, and then say, no problem, for $200 a month, we can set you up with an account and you can make those changes. That's an issue. Second issue is, very important to your business, this is one of the greatest ways your competitors can scam your business, and it happens all day, every day. We will often pull reports for a dealer's company and see that they have listings set up with their company name, their address, and another dealer's phone number that's happily answering the phones for them. And they never knew the difference. This has to be managed. One, it's got to be 100% accurate for lots of reasons. It's your business, it's your brand. In addition to that, these sites can generate leads and opportunities on their own, separate from your website. In addition to that, Google uses these sites to validate your company and the legitimacy of it. If the information is inaccurate, Google's not going to have as much credibility for your business. This can actually, these, managing them well, can help your business and your own personal website, your business website, perform better. Because there's validation, it's accurate. In order to get these done, we buy them in bulk. We buy a group of local listings. We say, I want 100 accounts on your system. We get the price down to nothing, because we're purchasing a whole bunch, and then we allow dealers to get into there. On a monthly basis, we do updates to these sites. These are just like your website. No updates, you don't keep adding content, you're not current, which means you're not relative, and Google's not gonna display that as an option, because it's old. So we do updates on a regular basis. In addition to that, we monitor all of the accounts for reviews. If you get a review, what's your responsibility? What do you need to do? Need to reply, need to encourage good behavior, need to respond positively to negative behavior. Here's the thing, if someone leaves a negative review and it's not legit, it doesn't matter. You can't get it removed, very rarely without a lot of work. You can't take it off, you gotta get over it. The reality is we've gotta focus on developing positive reviews. It needs to be part of our business, something we do day in, day out, every day, without fail. But you gotta know they exist. So every time a review comes in, we send a notification. Here's the benefit. I pulled one report for one client to see how their local listings were performing. This is where everyone starts. When we first get started managing the local listings, because we manage all 60 to 70 accounts for a particular company's address, one physical location. And usually they're not getting anything from them when they first start. They're not accurate. I bet if we pulled reports, which you guys, if you fill out that form, you'll get your local listing report in email. That's part of the evaluation. You'll notice on here over time, this is from August to August. It's 1 year. The more attribute changes, the more updates we do to it, the higher it grows, the more visible. This particular one had 584,000 views on search, 6,138 get directions requests, 11,500 phone calls, 19,434 clicks to their website. By the way, this is one listing of 60. That's phone calls, trackable. That's someone calls and it's the person that says, I found you on Google. And it's hard to track down which one they found you on. Because they've seen your listing so many times, one of them makes them convert. Make sense? You guys, this is free money. This is the easiest, simplest thing. To me, I consider this like telling my kids to clean their room. Just do it. You got to do it. You need to own your brand on this on the sites and leverage these to generate new business. Next, social media. Actually, I should skip. I'm going to come back to that. So we're going to go to reviews next. Step 5. Do you guys pay attention to those little stars on Google? You look at the stars as consumers? The answer is yes. If you're a shopper and you look online, everybody is moved by those stars. It either moves you closer, it moves you away, or it leaves you stuck and continue looking. It's either an exit or an entrance. If I Google your company name with the city you're in, there's going to be a little map that shows up. Hopefully you're on it. The way you get on that map, you got to have your listings, they got to be updated on a regular basis. Adding new photos, before and after, images, promotions, content. It has to be constantly updated. That map only works and comes up in the city you're physically located and is going to help you generate new business if it looks good to other people. Those stars matter. So the average review, it's hard for companies to get reviews because they're trying to figure out, how do I get somebody to go to Google? How do I get them to go leave us a review? We try and simplify it. Our dealers have an app on their phone called Nearby Now. Nearby Now is one of the only review systems that gives us the reviews in a format that we can later use on a website to actually show new content on a site in a new city. So what happens? They go on a job, they grab this little app, they check in. They say, installing a new air conditioning system. The phone knows that they're in a different city. So you'll notice all these different cities here. They know they're in Apple Valley. When they get done with the job, they ask the customer, are you guys happy with our work? They show them how to program the thermostat. They show them everything that they've done. Are you happy with the work? If they say no, just don't ask. There's a different process for that. I have a 1-800 number on the back of my card. Feel free to call that. Leave our customer service. If they love you, say, would you mind if I sent you a text message real quick? The lady in my office, she's crazy. I have to come back with a love note. Something. Get the review while you're in the home. Here's the beautiful part. When the review comes in, we get notified. We're able to route it where you need it, which means there's a brain behind it. We're not sending our reviews to HomeAdvisor where it's invisible to consumers or Yelp. We're sending it where you need it. Two most important places to get reviews. Number one, on Google Business Listing, that map. Why? Because it's one of the first things they see right under the ads. Second place that's most critical is on your website. Because every time you get a review in a new city, it gives you new valid content you didn't have to pay for, you didn't have to write, a new city page, and now the review is helping you get ranked on Google in all these other cities you want to do business in, and it costs you nothing. Now a review is helping you generate new business. That's logic. I want the work that I do to produce additional results. That's permanent. Compounding interest on your business. Make sense?
And just before you leave, I just want to tell y'all there is one of the dealers that's here, it's a man dealer, and including their website, Jennifer, Tom's. Last year, it's doing the Nearby Now. Love words, not But yep. That's the way you can grow your business into other locations as well. So this stuff does work. You know, it's just like anything, consistency and just, you know, getting with a program, because you're so busy on your own businesses, you can't be everything.
That's real. I mean, if you guys, this is just math. It's math. If you're interested in knowing how something looks, we show you the reports of the people we're doing it for. We show you how it's working, how it grows. Everything is transparent. It's requires a little bit of pain in the beginning to get through your website. Typically, that's not a fun process for people. It's just difficult. There's a lot of moving elements and a lot of moving pieces. But when you stick to it, you know you're in a plan and you know that every year I'm going to do something new. I'm going to do more of what works. I'm going to start eliminating the stuff I know doesn't work because I'm actually measuring it now. I'm going to reallocate it to something that does. You're going to see consistent progress. You're going to see consistent progress. All right. And part of it, you guys, is understanding the logic of how these things are connected. For example, social media. If a consumer goes to a great website and they happen to be somebody that only believes that if you're on Facebook and you've got current content, you're transparent and you're a scam if you're not. If you don't have it, that's an exit. So social media is an element. It builds trust in people. It shows transparency. At bare minimum, you could spend $100 a month and make sure at least the content that's going out is regular and branded for you. So now you can also generate leads and opportunities off social. There's different stages. So when you see step 6, social media, stage 1 is you need to look alive. Don't look closed. Don't look like you closed 2 years ago. But there's different stages to that as you continue to grow and you say, okay, I want to make social media be a part of generating new leads and business, and that's an option as well. You just have to go through the phases. Scale up, scale in. When it comes to social, it's as simple as this. One, it's got to be branded well. It's got to look professional. It's a business page, and they know that. Secondly, it's got to be fun. The content's got to be fun. It's supposed to be funny. They love kittens and babies online. Not saying do babies, but at least do dogs. You know, they're friendly. These are real people on the other line that live in this space. Women are attached to this 24/7. The majority of the entire planet lives on Facebook. It's what they do. So we can't just pitch them advertising. We don't respond. Consumers, people, we don't respond to advertising like we used to historically. They want different, they want transparency, they want fun, they want engagement, they want entertainment. Make it real, make it fun. Doing little things, we had one of our posts that it said, that lady was standing in front of a aisle of wine, and it said, looking for a good wine to pair with my allergy medication, indoor air quality. I mean, make it, that thing got 140 shares on it. They generated like 13 requests for somebody to come out and do work. You gotta make it fun. Make it fun. In addition to that, of course, you can use it also to build the business. Sparingly, you want to be careful. You want it to be fun and educational and informational. And then every once in a while throw in something that says, hey, we're doing a thermostat giveaway this month. You can apply online here or sign up to win or enter to win. What are we doing? We're driving them to a landing page, building that list, continuing to build the database for marketing in the future. We're building our activity on social media. Now it's becoming something that's an engaging area. People start to become fans. They think your jokes are cute. I don't know how our social media team does it, but they're funny. Great part is, if you use graphics that are branded as your content on social media, it's permanent. You can use them again next year. So if you don't want to do a big social media plan, do something small. Build the graphics. You don't have to do it. You have them design the graphics. And next year, you have all the graphics they designed from last year, plus you got the graphics from next year. What happens in year 3? You do it again. And now you still have this, you know, kind of minimal investment, but you're getting more and more content constantly without having to increase your spend. Because it's permanent. If I post content to a social media site, it's gone in seconds. If I post a graphic, it's permanent. It stays in the photo library and I can reuse it as often as I want. Make sense? Fantastic. All right, we talked about reviews. Next, search engine optimization. So here's the thing. Everything on page 1, these are fundamentals. Step 1 through 6. Website, content, CRM, local listings, reviews, social media. This is these things need to be done. That's your infrastructure. Without these things, if you spend money on any of these activities, I promise you, you're going to be someone that hates digital marketing companies because it doesn't work. If you spend money, I had a gentleman 2 days ago, he was spending $2,500 a month on SEO on a content that had technology that was 6 years outdated, cannot be crawled with no content for any of the services he sell. But they were happily taking $2,500 a month for SEO. Can't optimize that. If I get you on page one of Google for 150 key phrases and you've got two bad reviews, one good one, average rating of 2.8, phone's still not gonna ring. It's not gonna ring, even if you're sitting in that place. So these things have to be done properly. If your local listings are all messed up, but you're doing SEO, you won't get ranked quickly. It'll cause negative rankings. So you'll be spending money and not getting the return on the investment that you should be. So this page looks complicated and it's really messy. But really, it's math. What do you want to sell? Where do you want to sell it? You need page content for it. When that happens, I'm going to show you a report for one of our clients. This is typically what happens. When these guys came in, they didn't rank for anything. Website didn't rank anywhere, anytime, any place. This is, they think they've been online with us for about 4.5 months. They now have 483 phrases on the first page of Google, 255 phrases in the first position of Google. Those are their money makers. Why? Because when consumers search online, there's a list of options. It's the top 10 at the bottom that matter. Are you an option? That's it. Are you an option? It's that easy. Now, is it easy to get you there? That's a different story in a different class, but I won't bore you with that. All right. It is as simple as that. The case you're talking about, Tom's, he's here. He's not on an SEO plan. He had a website built. We wrote the content, I think, for 12 pages. He's sitting on page one of Google for 140 searches in one location with no SEO program. All we did is one-time SEO on the site. And for his particular situation, there wasn't too much competition, so he was able to get ranked. Let me actually, ooh, that got loud. Let me show you something. If you create a page on your website called Our Services, let me see if I can blow this up a little. There is a little number that shows right up here at the very top that tells you how many pieces of paper are in that drawer. How many pages are in this drawer? What do you guys see? If you have to think about how to say the number, we don't want that. Okay? That's a bad day. Okay? If I say heating, remember I said you need to be in the top 10 of this number in order to make any money. You need to be in the top 10 of this number in order to make any money. If I say heater, repair, let's go to Richmond. If I go heater, repair, Richmond, Texas, now how many pages do you have to compete with? Okay. So we have another client I met with just the other day, 2 days ago. They came in for a strategy session since we're in town. They've never done SEO. They just had us build a website. They're right here, easy blast. So we sat out at the pool and he was like, all right, I got my website. I'm done with step one, two, and I'm kind of done with three. What do I do next? And I was like, let's go look. So we went to his website and we pulled every page, the title of every page, and did a search to find out where he is, and we sat there in awe. Because we were like, you're sitting on page two, number three. The difference between page two, number three, and page one, number five. Is it a difference in your phone ringing? Yeah. That's money, no money. Page two, number three doesn't work. But he's halfway there and he hasn't done anything except have a new website with really well-written content and one-time SEO. We haven't made, in order for us to make a particular page rank, get to the front of Google, we have to make it popular. It's a long process to do that, but essentially we have to make it more popular than any of the other pages that are sitting there trying to be found. You'll notice here, this right now, without even looking at this site, I can tell you that is a nearby now city page that has been well optimized. They have 143 reviews in the area of Richmond, Texas. Which site stands out? Where's someone gonna click? This little starring system is called schema markup. There was a little window when we were able to do it without actually having the reviews. I think we did that for 7 months. Then all of a sudden Google said, oh, can't do that. You have to have the reviews to show the markup. But what's happening right now, and it's only happening for a small percentage of dealers and businesses out there, is they're using the review application to generate reviews. Pages are being created, the reviews are being displayed on the website, and we custom code the page to display those stars. So we literally have dealers sitting on page one, position six, that are ranking in the business as if they were number one only because of the stars. Not everybody looks like that, you notice? That is a game changer. That's a huge opportunity for you, and it's only a huge opportunity until everyone does it, which is why you can never stay stagnant. It's why we're always calling dealers and sending them messages going, something's new, we gotta talk, there's something cool, there's something new, because we need to constantly be changing and taking advantage of these moments. Okay, in here, you guys do the same thing for your area. Here's the math. When you first start off with a well-designed, well-developed website, good content, it takes us about 30 days per 100,000 competitive pages to get the page to rank on page one. That's our math. That's in year one. Our dealers that have been with us for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, fit now we have some for 15 years, it doesn't take that long because their website has so much weight and power online that they can say, hey, Jen, we want to sell blank now in this city. We'll go, okay, let's write the content. We just had one. They called us up and they're like, we want to sell boilers. We're doing boilers now. They're based in New Jersey. Created one page of content, put it on the website, optimized it, and in 6 days we had it from the back of Google to the front of Google sitting on page one, and they got their first call. They've been with us for 10 years. They didn't quit. They stuck to it, kept adding, and continued to make progress. Make sense? Getting there? I know this stuff's complicated. It's actually pretty easy. All right. So, search engine optimization, it's as simple as this. For this particular site, actually, I'm sorry, for this search phrase, so, yes, 2 minutes. For this search phrase, one phrase, all three of our dealers are sitting there, and they've eliminated all the other options for page one. Which one stands out? You look at it and say, which one would you click?
One with the star.
There you go. For this particular page, this is the searches Duckless System Maintenance in Titusville, Florida. Just so you see the search, these are the ads. This is one of our customers. They've been with us, I want to say about 8 years now. We handed this to a room full, we're always testing people, we handed it to a room full of people and said, which one would you click on? Which one's went in the business? It's really tiny, but they all said the same thing. They said, number seven, we're going with number seven. Here's the reality. For this particular search, we own, for our company, page one, position one through eight. There are only two other options on the entire page. It was the same company over and over and over again, and they said they were adamantly going with number seven. Page one, position one, it's the same business. They actually argued it and why. They got in a big debate, discussed it, which I think is entertaining. Compounding results is what we're in. These guys, I'm proud of these guys. And they went from someone that didn't exactly say everything was going to work. Their website is done. Their content is written. They keep adding new content. Now they've added video. They're already on to step 11. They're adding video content. If you do searches for specific phrases, their website's coming up. Their local listings are coming up. Their social media is coming up. And their videos are coming up. And there are no other options for that particular service in that marketplace. They win. They win it all. They haven't done this yet, pay-per-click, and they might not have to. Here's the reality. Pay-per-click on this page, or PPC, it's number 10. Most companies start off, and this is where they want to start. In fact, most manufacturers, this is how they make their dealers market their company, and I love working with the Manna because they don't. In a pay-per-click environment, you burn through cash to show up in the ads. Your cost is not the cost per click. Your cost is the cost per conversion. If you went through 40 clicks at $20 a piece, your cost is the total volume that you had to pay in order to get one deal to close. Problem is, if you do a service call for $300, you got a 60% margin on that you lost from day one. If you spend your money on pay-per-click continuously, you burn through it, you're out of it, and you have nothing left after it. That's simple interest versus compounding interest. If you have to do this, utilizing an ad network for a pay-per-call at least will prevent you from burning through cash for just clicks that don't convert. That's an option. If you're going to do any PPC, pay-per-click, pay-per-call, it has to be for an immediate need, an immediate reason, and then you got to have a plan to get out of it. You got to have a plan to have something permanent work for you so you don't have to burn through cash like this. There are two pieces on here. I'm actually getting through the whole thing. Number 9 and number 12. Those are two pieces to remind you that you got to take time for your database. You got to take time for your existing customers. There has to be a plan in place to help encourage repeat business, referral business, to stay in touch with existing customers. That has to be part of the marketing plan. They are technically the best source of new business for the least expense if you stay in communication with them, but we're always hunting for the new customer. We forget about the existing ones. I love that you guys get busy during the summer because all we do is focus on our existing accounts. That's all we do. We're not speaking, we're not traveling. You have to make time to be able to do that as well. Here's your rationale. In the beginning, as a business owner, you're thinking, how much do I want to spend? When you learn the math, and when you see the results, when you do the right things in the right order at the right time, the difference is instead of having a conversation internally about how much do you want to spend on marketing, you guys will start talking about how much do we want to make? What do we want to sell? Where do we want to sell it? What do we want to sell? Where do we want to sell it? And you'll start to see. You got to know your math. Average ticket price at $300, 60% profit, your website is paid for if you get 20 service calls. Average ticket price of $4,000, we'll go conservative, 45%. You got marketing paid for your first 3 months with 3 installs. The math works out once you guys make progress. I hope this is helpful, you guys. If you have not, fill this out. We'll do an absolutely complimentary evaluation, set up a strategy session. We'll give you insights on what you should do first based on where you're currently at, where you want to go. And if you want to work with us, fantastic. If you want to take this back to your marketing company and ruffle up some feathers, fantastic. We're here either way. Other than that, I hope this was helpful and I appreciate you guys taking the time.